2 and an Akron third down.
I don't know. Patrick Geshan and Luke West Poley back with you here at the Yager Stadium in Oxford, Ohio. We apologize for some major technical difficulties we're having this evening. It is a third down and one for Akron with 12:40 to go in the first quarter. The Zips winning the opening opening coin toss, and they get the first drive. So it's their own ball on the right hash from the 45-yard line and a handoff here, and they are going to be tackled for no gain. Patrick Geshan, Luke West Poley with you here. We thank you for sticking with us during these technical difficulties. And Luke, the RedHawks here, will have to come up with a stop on a fourth down and one, and Akron's going to put the punt team on. What do you make of the matchup here tonight?
Well, I think it's a really good matchup for both sides. Akron's still looking for that first win of the season. They're playing against a Miami team that has nothing to play for now, as they've already become bowl eligible and secured a spot in the MAC championship game. And I think on the RedHawks side, just winning a game, you know, would be a big confidence builder and even put them into a better bowl game. So both sides with a lot to play for tonight.
So we're doing this game off of my MacBook microphone because our equipment is not working properly at all right now. We apologize for that. The basketball broadcast earlier today messed it all up, as a fair catch is caught by Maurice Thomas back at the Miami 18-yard line after the Akron punt. So we'll work on the technical difficulties. We hope you can hear us okay. There's 11:41 to go in the first quarter. We'll keep it right here for a media timeout as we'll try to fix our equipment. We'll be back in a moment. This is Miami Football on Red Hawk Radio.
Please direct your attention to the south end zone. We would like to take this opportunity to remember the incredible cost paid by those who gave their all to help preserve the freedoms we enjoy, those gallant individuals who fought and died for our country. Yet it is remembering our fallen comrades that we are reminded of those who say is still unknown, those still listed as missing in action and prisoners of war. Joining President Craig and Dr. Renata Crawford, along with Director of Institutional Relations Randy Thomas tonight, to thank the Miami University Missing in Action and Prisoners of War Empty Chair is Senator Bill Poley, Representative Rick Morales, Buckeye Boys State Director Jim Coppin, Department Americanism and Children and Youth Coordinator Christy White, Department Commander Roger Friend, Buckeye Boys State First Vice President Ronald Chapman, Department VA&R and National Security Coordinator Jermaine Ferguson, Boys State Alumni Colin Finn, and Zach Moore. More than 78,000 Americans are still unaccounted for from World War II, 8,100 from Korea, 120 from the Cold War, 1,810 from Vietnam, and 3 from the Gulf War. These courageous Americans dedicated their lives to preserving and protecting our freedom will never be forgotten. Those who have served and those currently serving in uniformed services of the United States are ever mindful that the sweetness of enduring peace has always been attained by the bitterness of personal sacrifice. Thank you.
Patrick Geshan, Luke West Poley with you here. We're having some major technical difficulties here from Yager Stadium tonight, and we're very glad you're with us here on this Wednesday evening. Miami and Akron in college football match in action. 11:41 to go here in the first quarter. RedHawks are going to get their first offensive drive of the game. Brett Gabbert will hand off to the far side. Jalen Walker's going to pass it down right side of the field, and it's tipped up in the air and almost intercepted by Akron. The RedHawks looking downfield for Jack Sorensen, number 13, who's standing at the Akron 45-yard line, but they couldn't connect with him on the pass. And it'll be second and 10 here in the first.
Yeah, it looks like Walker's going to lose a lot of yards on the run there until he dropped back to pass and just severely underthrows Jack Sorensen there. Three Akron Zips right around him. Should have been intercepted there. And Miami's going to get lucky. They're going to have a second down here.
It'll be second and 10 from the left hash. Three men in the backfield along with Gabbert. They have two receivers right and one to the left. with 5 on the play clock here waiting for the snap, and it's going to be a bad snap with a flag coming out before the play gets going. False start on Miami here, and they will be back 5 yards. It'll be 2nd and 15 from the 13-yard line. Two receivers right, one to the left. Gabbert will clap once. With the same formation here coming up for Miami. Hand off to the right side, it's Jalen Bester. Gets to the 15-yard line. He's pushed back there. A flag comes out during the run on his 2nd and 15. Bester maybe got a gain of 5 on the play. And the referee's here trying to decide what the call is. So again, we apologize, having some major technical difficulties here from Yager Stadium. We're calling this game off of a laptop microphone right now. This is going to be holding here against Akron. So we're trying to figure out those technical difficulties. And we apologize. Is on the right hash here. The Redhawks gonna have a 2nd and 2 from their own 26. Gabbert has 3 receivers to the left and 1 to the right. And a man in the backfield with him. He's gonna hand off to that man. It looks like it's Tyree Shelton. And Shelton will be stopped for no gain for the Redhawks here on a 2nd and 2. And it will turn into a 3rd and 2. Tyree Shelton had 31 yards in the game last week against Bowling Green. 17 was his longest run. 387 yards coming into the season. No gain on the play for Tyree Shelton. 10:35 to go in the first quarter. 3rd and 2 for the Redhawks from the right hash. It is a pistol formation here for Miami. They have 2 receivers left and 1 to the right. As Bester now will move to Gabbert's right in the backfield. Gabbert takes a snap, pitch play far side. Bester gets a first down and a lot more up to the Miami 42-yard line. That's where he stopped. Big pick up there for Jalen Bester. Redhawks get a first down.
Yeah, it's a good read by Gabbert on the read option. Didn't have any space to run, throws it out to Bester on the far side. He accelerates up ahead for a gain of 20 plus yards, and the Redhawks are rolling early.
Next play on the no huddle offense, a quick handoff on the left side. Jalen Bester running it again for a gain of 4 for the Redhawks on a 2nd down. 2 receivers right and 1 to the left. Gabbert claps once, we'll hand it off. And up the left side again, it's Bester. Jalen Bester comes in 436 yards on the year. That by far leads the Redhawks in rushing. He has 9 rush touchdowns this year, including 2 last week in the game against Bowling Green. And the Redhawks here are gonna have a 3rd and 4 coming up from their own 46-yard line with 9:21 to go in the first quarter. As there's 2 receivers to the right and 1 to the left here for the Redhawks. Gabbert claps twice, the handoff up the left hash, climbing his way just barely for a first down. Dodging the tackles across the 50-yard line into Akron territory is Tyree Shelton. Gain of 5 for him. Redhawks will get a 1st and 10 for the Akron 49. Patrick Geshan, Luke Westpulley with you here tonight on Redhawk Radio as calling this off a laptop microphone right now as we get our equipment up and working here. Gabbert play action fake. He's gonna go long down the field over the middle, just out of the reach of the intended target down there. And it appeared to be Dominic Robinson. As Robinson was all the way down at the Akron 5-yard line as he was trying to go deep on a 1st and 10, turns into a 2nd and 10 for the Akron 49. Two receivers left and 1 to the right. Gabbert will move a man next to him. Then a pitch to the far side, and that man is Maurice Thomas, who's across the 45-yard line out of bounds, 2 yards shy of the first down. It'll be a third and two here coming up for Maurice Thomas. 8:20 to go here in the first quarter. There's two receivers right and one to the left. And no huddle offense continuing on here for Miami. Gabbard in the gun. Wolf handed off and up the left side. It's Maurice Thomas again to pick up another first down for the Redhawks. We see Tyree Shelton, Maurice Thomas, and Jalen Bester all rush the ball for the Redhawks in this game. So make substitutions here after the first down run. Crowd tonight is a little bit better than it was last week. A somewhat more full student section. Probably 100 students are here and general admittance crowd. It's a lot warmer than it was last week too, about 15 degrees warmer. Temperature's just in the low 40s. A receiver on either side here. Gabbard claps twice, gets the handoff. Bester up the right hash across the 35, down to the 34-yard line. And Jalen Bester will create here a second and six coming up for the Redhawks. Down to 7:13 to go in the first. Gabbert was back for a pass in the next play, and he gets parried down by Akron. Pocket collapsing very quickly. Brett Gabbert is brought down for a loss of five, and third and 11 is coming up here for the Redhawks.
Yeah, it's just a three-step drop here for Gabbert. Doesn't go that far back into the pocket. Tried to step up and make a play, but no receivers really open downfield. That pocket collapsed on him pretty quickly. He's going to get sacked now. They're going to have a third and long. They're just outside field goal range.
Two receivers left, one to the right for Gabbert. The man next to him in the backfield appears to be Tyree Shelton. Gabbert claps twice, gets the snap off, looking near side for a pass, and almost intercepted there by Akron. A little slant route that time for the Redhawks. And it was Dominic Robinson, the intended target again, with 6:29 to go here in the first quarter. It's a 4th-and-11 for Miami from the Akron 39, and they're going to bring on Kyle Kramer here to punt. Sam Sloman on this drive. Kyle Kramer, three punts. 43 was his longest last week against Bowling Green, averaging 38 on the year. Right-footed punter and an overhand kick. Fair catch is made at the 5-yard line by Akron's returner. And that is number 82, Jeremiah Knight, out of Jefferson, Ohio. So it's 6:23 to go here in the first quarter. Akron's going to get the ball back on drive number two of the game, and we'll be back in a moment. It's Miami Football on Red Hawk Radio, working on some technical difficulties.
Hey, students, check under your seats. If you have the special lucky seat dryer under your seat, you just won pizza for a semester, courtesy of Miami Athletics. Swoop and the cheerleaders are headed into the stands to give you your dryer. So stand up and show us your dryer.
Thank you, my friends and family, for all the support and the great effort for me for this long road. It's been a lot of fun. I can't wait to go on.
Hits on Saturday at home, your Miami volleyball team defeated Western Michigan in three sets, and the Redhawks earned the 2019 MAC regular season championship for the fourth straight season. Congratulations, Miami volleyball! Live with CKC Rebels, Oxford's off-campus housing with amazing uptown views. We are where you want to be. CKCRebels.com.
Do you have another cord?
No.
I play football. I always have.
It's not that it's too cold, because it worked. Patrick Geshan and Luke West Poley back with you here at Yager Stadium. Akron is back to pass, and they fire down the right side of the field, but it's incomplete. Akron pinned all the way back to their own 6-yard line right now to begin this second drive of the game. Their quarterback is number one in their white uniforms this evening. His name is Kato Nelson, a 6'1", 215 redshirt junior out of Hollywood, Florida, who last week went 20 for 33 for one interception, 288 yards, and two touchdowns. Rush for 0 yards, and Kato Nelson, the redshirt junior, trying to lead the Akron team to their first one of the year. They haven't had one yet. 0-10 overall coming into this game. Kato Nelson's going to be tackled for a safety. Back at the 6-yard line, he took 3 steps in the backfield. Oh, never mind. The referee now ruling that his forward progress was stopped all the way back at the 1-yard line, and so that will negate the safety. Still going to be a 3rd and 15 coming up for Akron, though, at the 1, as the RedHawks have done a great job pinning them in their own end so far, Luke.
Yeah, they brought a lot of pressure, and they've already had almost 2 safeties on both of these plays at the pass rush. And a big 3rd down coming up here for Akron. Not sure if they're just going to run it and punt this one away, or if they're going to want to take the risk of risking another safety and trying to go downfield and pick up the 1st down.
2 receivers left and 1 to the right here for Kato Nelson. He's got a man in the backfield next to him to his left. And that's his favorite running back target, Peter Hayes Patrick, who now moves to Kato Nelson's right. 3 on the play clock. They're taking their time here. We get a whistle before the snap and a timeout called by the Zips with 5:14 to go in the first. And so it'll be the 2nd charge timeout to Akron, and we'll step aside. It's Miami Football on Red Hawk Radio.
Dan wants to keep us, and that means we turn to our next contestant, Mitchell. Since Dan kept the football, you now get to pick what's under box 1 or 2. Which do you pick?
Box 2.
All right, let's reveal your prize. First under box number 1, you would have won
a
brand new car, courtesy of Matchbox.
I never shut down.
But instead, you took box number 2, meaning you had just won an Apple TV.
I don't think that's the problem.
Yeah, I don't either.
Red Hawks went to other Red Hawk fans and enjoyed the drink. Specials and free chips and salsa throughout the entire game. Go Red Hawks.
Patrick Geshan and Luke West Poley back with you here at Yager Stadium in Oxford, Ohio. Again, we are working through some major technical difficulties tonight, and we appreciate you for sticking with us. As Akron punted on a fourth down on their last drive, and so the RedHawks with it now on the Akron 29. They just ran it up the right hash for a second down at 7 with 4:10 to go in the first quarter. As our audio board is not connecting to our control switch that sends the broadcast to YouTube, and so we have been working on that. We believe a cord is broken or something in the basketball game earlier today. Gabbard a pass to the left side of the field now, and making the catch and running up the near side appears to be Tyree Shelton, who has made some good catches for the RedHawks throughout the past few games, but running back is his specialty. It'll be a 3rd and 2 coming up here for the RedHawks from the Akron 24. Patrick Geshan and Luke West-Poley with you here from Yager Stadium tonight. As the RedHawks line up to the field now, and Gabbard will have a man to his right, and Jalen Bester, two receivers right, one to the left. Gabbard clapped once, waiting for the snap. Now claps twice. It's a handoff and tackled immediately there. Was the man in the backfield next to him, Jalen Bester, who gets stopped at the 26-yard line way before the first down marker of the 22, and it's going to be a 4th and 4 coming up. So Sam Sloman's going to be on here. He's going to attempt a 44-yard field goal for the RedHawks at 2:45 to go in the first. As Sloman, last week, 1 for 1, he made a 27-yarder against Bowling Green, 53 the career long. He's 17 for 20 on the season. A long kick here. It has the height, it has the distance, and it is good from Sam Sloman. And with 2:31 to go in the first quarter, it's Miami 3, Akron nothing. And look, a decent first few drives for the RedHawks, and this time able to convert.
Yeah, you know, and I think this all just started off with a big stop on the defensive side. They were able to pin the zips inside their own 5-yard line. And a punt return by Maurice Thomas left them already in field goal range when they started their drive. Weren't able to get a whole ton of offense going, but they're, I'm sure, excited to get on the board first with 2:31 here to go in the first.
So the RedHawks kicking team will get going. Now Miami is going to the MAC championship game. They'll be playing in Detroit on December 7th against a team that's still to be determined. It's either going to be Central Michigan or Western Michigan. Western Michigan playing Tuesday night at NIU. Central Michigan playing Friday against Toledo at 12 p.m. Eastern time. And it's either going to be one of those two teams who are currently tied at 5-2 each in the MAC West Conference. The RedHawks, with the Kent State victory over Buffalo last week, are for sure going to the MAC championship. And of course, their win against Bowling Green last week helped as well. Two games left on the schedule for Miami, Ball State in this one, before the postseason starts, as Sloman kicks a kick back out the back of the end zone. And Luke, let's talk about this team's mentality here going into these final two games of the year, because they already know they're going to the MAC championship and they're already bowl eligible. So how do you approach these final games of the season?
Well, I think this is just a matter of, you know, especially for your seniors and, you know, people like that, how do you want to, you know, leave your legacy? How do you want to end your season? Because the RedHawks this year could end up, you know, with 10 wins this year, or they could, you know, they could end up, what, 6-8 if they lose the MAC championship and their bowl game. So really, this could go, you know, a variety of different ways for the RedHawks. So I think they just need to maintain a positive mentality and, you know, want to play in one of those good bowl games instead of, you know, being 6-6.
3-0 they lead it. Cato Nelson on play number one of the Akron drive fires it over the right side of the field, and it's caught by the Akron wide receiver Julian Hicks, the 6'3", 200 redshirt sophomore from nearby Cleveland. He had 1 touchdown, 7 receptions for 41 yards in the game last week. The Zips played it with was a 42-14 loss against Eastern Michigan. Week before, a 35-6 loss at Bowling Green, the team the RedHawks beat last week 44-3. Empty backfield for Nelson, three receivers left, but he's looking right for a pass, and it's just out of the reach of the intended target, Brandon Lee, who made just one catch last year, or last week rather, for Akron. So a second and 10 comes up here from their own 40, inside 2 minutes to go now in the first quarter. And we hope you can hear us okay from Yager Stadium tonight. Again, working through some technical difficulties this evening. We're going to try to get those fixed as soon as possible, but down to one microphone right now, and Luke and I are sharing it. As Nelson has three receivers left. An empty backfield, fires far side, and it's a catch for Akron, and going for a first down out the far side of the field is Timothy Scipio, number 88 in white, who is going to pick up 12 yards for the Zips. They're into Miami territory now to the RedHawk 48, and it's going to be a first and 10 here.
Just a stutter step move on the far side, froze a couple of the RedHawks defenders who were unblocked, and also pretty good blocking there by the Zips on the screen play, able to pick up a big chunk of yardage and a first down now into Miami territory.
Two receivers right and one to the left here for Kato Nelson. Gets this snap, walks it back to inside Akron territory, long one down the right side, and it's a catch. Akron brings it in, number 5, Nate Stewart, the wide receiver, all the way down to the Akron 5-yard line. Gets behind the RedHawks coverage, and they'll officially mark him down at the 8 with all the progress. First down and goal from the 8-yard line for Akron, and the no-huddle offense will continue here for the Zips. They have two on the left and one on the right. Nelson takes the snap, walks it back, he's sacked immediately. Sterling Weatherford for the RedHawks broke on the right side of the line, and he will send Akron back about 4 or 5 yards here to the 12-yard line. It'll be second and goal from the 12 for the Zips.
Yeah, the play action really didn't fool anybody for the RedHawks there on defense. Just walked right around the blocker and were able to get to Nelson before he could really have much of a look at anything in terms of where his receivers were at. And now a bit more difficult here to convert. Second goal to go on the 12-yard line.
With inside a minute to go here in the first quarter, two receivers right and one to the left. A snap back is caught at the 20-yard line. Nelson in trouble. Man on him, fires it over the middle, and it hit the ground immediately to be incomplete. As Cato Nelson was driven all the way back to his own 20-yard line on that play, had no options for him in the end zone. It's going to be a third and goal from the 12-yard line for Akron with 17 seconds to go in the first.
Yeah, and this pass rush has really been a strength for the RedHawks in the past 2 weeks, showing it again today. Already, they've really hurried Nelson up and already sacked him a couple times, and they made it a lot tougher for him here to get that ball off and get that ball off quick. See if Akron makes the adjustment. We've already seen some successful screen plays and quick throws. Look to see more of that here later in this game.
With two receivers left and one to the right, Nelson is going to be back to pass here at the 20-yard line. Now rush it forward, and he's brought down. Redhawks make the tackle as Cato Nelson just one man to beat before having a nice run at things, but it was the linebacker Ivan Pace Jr. for the RedHawks who got his left hand right on Nelson's foot to bring him down back at the 16. And it's going to be fourth and goal from the 16 here for Akron. And that's going to end the festivities here in the first quarter. So after 15 minutes of play here from Oxford, the Miami RedHawks lead the Akron Zips by a score of 3-0. We'll try to solve our technical difficulties and be back with you in just a moment here from Yager Stadium. It's Miami football on RedHawk Radio.
Fans, please direct your attention.
Wait.
Now we have it.
We do?
Test. Hold on.
Wait. It keeps switching. Hold on. Test, test.
Let's go.
Let's go. Thank you to everyone listening in, by the way. Oh, man. Yes. Oh, what a relief.
I know, Mom, that I'm on and off. My mom texts me, you're on and off. Yeah, I fucking know it.
Are we muted?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
I don't think we are. We are not muted.
Second quarter about to begin here for the Yager Stadium in Oxford. We got a field goal coming for Akron from the right hash, and a long kick is through and good for their field goal kicker. That is number 41, Corey Smigel, the 5'8", 150 redshirt freshman on North Royalton, Ohio. He is now four for five on the year. 35 is his longest of the season. Corey Smigel now will tie the game at three, and a drive there, Luke, for Akron that produced a field goal. We're tied here at three. It didn't look very good when they had it first to goal at the eight. They kept getting pushed back, but able to get the field goal through.
Yeah, obviously not able to cover, you know, work some of the details, I guess is the right word for that, late in that drive, giving up a couple sacks on those goal-to-go plays. But they're able to tie this game, you know, in a game that's low scoring through the first quarter, only got six total points between the two teams. You know, a lot of defensive-minded things for both teams. I'm sure they're happy just to get points on the board.
3-3-year score here, 14:57 to go in the second quarter, and a long kickoff coming for Akron. It is Jerry Fitchin, a redshirt junior out of Orange, California, who gets it back for a touchback far side of the field. All right, so we fixed our technical errors here. Luke and I are back talking into headsets now rather than a laptop microphone. And we are now all set and comfortable. We appreciate you for sticking with us through all that difficulty. We know we were on and off the air. But back on now for good, hopefully. Gabbard here on the right hash for the RedHawks, with two receivers left and one to the right. He's going to move the man in the backfield to his left next to him. And it's a handoff to that guy. It's Tyree Shelton, who climbs his way up to the 29-yard line from the 25 to pick up four on a first and 10. The Hawks begin the offensive work here in the second quarter. Ball will be here on the 28-yard line for the RedHawks. The Akron 28, or their own 28-yard line.
We're in our tech minds right now, not as much our calling game minds.
tell you what, it's been a night so far.
It has been.
Oh, my goodness. Two receivers left, one to the right. Gabbard is three men in the backfield, and there's a flag coming in here before the snap. For a false start on the RedHawks, it appears. The ref mic again very quiet tonight, so we are probably not going to be able to bring that to you. As they really need to fix that here at Yager Stadium, I feel like. With 14 minutes now to go in the second quarter, RedHawks push back for a second and 12 on the 23-yard line. There's two receivers to the left and one to the right. As Gabbert will clap twice here, hands off to the man to his left, and that is Davion Johnson, who gets to the 25-yard line. And he will have a third and 10 here now from the Akron 25. As the Miami Athletic Department looks for the sweep of the day, the men's basketball team beating Central State earlier today by a score of 80-45 at Millett Hall. And be nice to make it a 2-0 Wednesday with Maction on the nightcap. The receivers on either side as Gabbert here will clap again and walk it back to the RedHawks zone 15. Long pass far side. It's a catch. And do they give forward progress for a first down here? It looks like they will. The chains are going to move on a third and 10. Nice grab down there on the far side of the field by the RedHawks wide receiver, number 8, Luke Bolden.
Yeah, and Gabbert's barely able to get this throw off in time. There's an Akron defensive end closing on him pretty hard. He's able to get the throw off, though. Just a good medium-range pass, and the RedHawks pick up the first down. And moving a little bit slower here than we're used to seeing.
Yep. The no-huddle offense really was driving the offense in the first couple of sequences, but now the Rocks taking their time. Hand off to Bester, finds a lane up the right side of the field, and Jalen Bester has plenty of blockers all the way down to the Akron 30-yard line. Jalen Bester is going to pick up at least 60 yards on this rush, and very early on you knew he was going a long distance, Luke.
Yeah, he's got that acceleration already in the backfield. When you see that hole start to open up, he's got all kinds of open field in front of him. And gets about 5 more yards after contact, and just a big chunk of yardage there from Davion Johnson, or Jalen Bester rather. And the RedHawks are now in field goal range again and looking to put more points than just 3 up on the board here.
Two receivers left and one to the right. Gabbert pass to the far side. It's a catch. Tyree Shelton gets to the numbers of the 30-yard line, and didn't look good there for a second for Tyree Shelton, but he's out of bounds far sideline after a gain of 8. Actually, 9 they're going to give him. But officially, it'll be 2nd and 2 from the Akron 21. The RedHawks pushing here toward the red zone. The ball going to be on the left hash. No huddle offense is back. Gabbert claps once, hands off to the man behind him. That's Tyree Shelton, and into the end zone for a touchdown. Tyree Shelton, right after that play, gets a handoff on the left hash, runs it in from 21 yards outside, and the Miami RedHawks retake the lead, 9-3 over the Akron Zips with 11:32 to go in the second quarter.
Really explosive drive there from the RedHawks, fueled by some big things from the backfield, and it's going to be Tyree Shelton who's going to get the touchdown for Miami. But just an overall great drive there for the Miami running backs in the line. Had a couple explosive runs, and they're up once again here in the second.
Sam Sloman, a long field goal kick here. We'll give Miami a 10-3 lead on the PAT. He is 4-for-5 in that department last week, 24-for-25 on the season, and the Miami RedHawks early on in the second quarter retake the lead on a Tyree Shelton run for a touchdown. 11:32 to go in the second. It's Miami football on Red Hawk Radio. Back to Maction in a moment. Back here at Yager Stadium on a Wednesday night, 11:32 to go in the second quarter. Here from Oxford, Ohio, the Miami RedHawks leading the Akron Zips by a score of 10-3. Patrick Geshan, Luke Westpoli, glad you're with us along for the ride. Maction here, the RedHawks' final home game of the year as well. They'll be on the road at Ball State the Friday after Thanksgiving, a 12 p.m. startup in Muncie. And then the MAC Championship December 7th, also a 12 p.m. start from Detroit. Ford Field is where that game is played. Rock's hockey team has also played a few games at Ford Field. On kickoff here from Sloman from the far side of the field, and it's caught here for a return by Akron's Jeremiah Knight, who gets up to the 22-yard line. That's where he's tripped up by the RedHawks defense, who meets him there. 11:25 to go in the second. Akron will have it first and 10 from their own 21. So that's where the drive begins here for Cato Nelson and company. It's a pretty good crowd, Luke, for a Wednesday night.
Yeah, and bigger than last week. Yeah. Weather permitting, I guess, but not as much to play for the RedHawks here in terms of just pure statistics and what the fans know.
Nelson hands off up the middle of the field. His favorite running back, number 25, Peter Hayes Patrick, a 6'10", 6'0", 210 freshman out of Orlando, Florida. Only 79 yards for him coming into the season. This Akron team is a passing team. That is really the blueprint of their offense. As last week in the game against Bowling Green, 342 total yards, 288 of those were pass yards. Second and six coming up here from the middle of the field. Nelson from the gun is it two receivers on either side. Empty backfield opens up. Two flags come in right at the snap with movement. The referees here will huddle together to decide who moved first, as there was certainly movement at the line before the snap came in. It's going to be a false start on Akron and push him back 5 yards to their own 20, and it'll be a second and 11 from there.
Yeah, that was just an awkward snap from the start. Not really, well, we weren't really sure initially who that penalty was going to be on. But just kind of an odd sequence with movement all across the board there. Zips looking to respond after the RedHawk touchdown.
10.5 to go in the second. Two receivers on either side. Nelson backfires far into the field, and it's a catch. Brought in there by Julian Hicks, who makes his second reception of the day, and he's going to pick up about 9 yards for the Zips on that play to make it a 3rd and 2 from the 29, and they give themselves a very manageable third down difference here. And no huddle continues with two receivers left and one to the right. Nelson hands off and set back before it could even get a chance at the first down. It was Hayes Patrick. Trying to go up the right hash of the field, but the RedHawks met him with four red jerseys. The 28-yard line, it's going to be a 4th and 3 on a loss of 1 from the Akron 28. And I'd say they're pretty generous with that forward progress. Akron's going to bring the punt team on here. And we'll see Jonah Weiland, the 6'1", 219 redshirt sophomore out of Hudson, Ohio. Averaging about 34.25 yards per punt last week. He had 4. In the game against EMU. Good one here, spiraling kick, Maurice Thomas, middle of the field, fair catch is made at the Miami 36-yard line. Rucks here are gonna get the ball on the next offensive drive with 9:17 to go in the second. And we'll get immediate timeout out of this as well. So Miami will try to begin. Next offensive drive with some more spark, just like they did last time. They lead a 10-3 over the Akron Zips. 9:17 to go in the second quarter. It's Miami football on Red Hawk Radio. 9:17 to go in the second quarter. Patrick Geshan, Luke West Poley with you here from Yager Stadium in Oxford tonight. Glad you're with us on a Wednesday night. A humid Wednesday night. Rocks here are going to begin the next offensive drive. They got two receivers on the right and one on the left. And Gabbert with a man in the backfield next to him. Looks like it's Jalen Bester, who's had a lot of great rushes today, including a touchdown rush. Pass to the near side. Andrew Holmer, the tight end, will make the catch and rush himself out of bounds after a gain of 8 yards. As Holmer has emerged as a large candidate to get the ball from Gabbert in the air. Over the past few games, he's made some pretty good catches. Second and two, Bester handoff up the left hash. He's got a break. Jalen Bester up the far side, shoved out of bounds at the 30-yard line. As Jalen Bester there, they only needed about 2 yards for the first down, but he got into Akron territory deep, and another good rush there. And Luke, for Jalen Bester, keeps racking up the running yards tonight.
Yeah, hole just opens up in the line early. He flies through that, makes his way down towards the far side of the field. He's going to step out of bounds at the 30-yard line, and just really explosive, and the RedHawks running backs have just done a great job on those long runs so far in tonight's game.
The receivers right in a bunch formation. Gabbert play action handoff here with Johnson. Fires over the middle. Wide open is Jack Sorensen. And he was at the 15-yard line, far side of the field. Could have gone a little bit longer, but tripped up. And his progress halted down at the 14-yard line, but Knox are in the red zone now. A pickup of 16 for Sorensen and a first down. No huddle offense continues. Empty backfield. Gabbert passes far side and flings it way out of the field. As early on, realizing when the pocket collapsed, he had no options to pass to. So it'll be his second attempt coming up from the Akron 14. Receivers on the right here for the RedHawks. In this next formation, they'll have three on the left. Robert has a man next to him in the backfield. Looks like that's Tyree Shelton. But they don't afford to go in the second. Shelton the handoff, moving toward the near side of the field. Breaks through at the 10, down to the 5. He's stripped up there. Tyree Shelton will get down to the 4-yard line, and that might be enough for a first and goal. And it looks like it is, so the RedHawks have it. First and goal from the 4 on the right hash. We'll have three receivers here to the left and one to the right. And Gabbert will stand back at his own 9-yard line to get the snap. Hands it off. Shelton up the left side, trying to get through the line. He did for a second, but was stopped just short of the goal line. Tyree Shelton gets him inside the 1-yard line here with 7:35 to go in the second. It's going to be a second and goal for the RedHawks. Gabbert here standing back at his own 6. Gets the snap. Shelton a leap for the goal line. The ball came loose. And Akron says they have it. As they're going to mark him down at the 1. It looks like the RedHawks going to keep the ball. It's going to be a 3rd and goal here as Shelton trying to leap up Luke, but could not get over the pile of about 10 players down there huddled around the goal line.
Yeah, and he reached that ball out and really exposed it to the entire Akron defensive line, rather. And they were able to punch it out of his hand. The ball was just completely exposed to them. RedHawks get a lucky break that they are able to hold that ball inside the 1.
Hand off here, trying to charge up the middle. Jalen Bester in for the touchdown for Miami. Now Jalen Bester in a pistol formation got the handoff up the right hash, took 3 quick steps, and just like that, broke through the line, and the Miami RedHawks now with a 2-possession lead, 16-3 over Akron with 6:45 to go in the second. Sam Sloman on here for the PAT. And he will make that without a problem. Sam Sloman, perfect in that department. Today, he's only missed one of those on the season. Miami takes a 17-3 lead with 6:45 rather to go here in the second quarter. It took a while for the RedHawks offense to get moving in the first quarter, but they're ready to go and piped up here in the second. It's Miami football on RedHawk Radio from Yager Stadium. 6:45 to go in the second quarter. RedHawks going to kick off here after another touchdown-producing drive. This time, Jalen Bester running it into the end zone for the RedHawks, and Sam Sloan with the ball on the far hash here as Miami kicks left to right across your radio in quarter number two. RedHawks up by 14 here from Yager Stadium tonight. And Luke mentioned a bigger crowd than last Wednesday's game against Bowling Green. I'd say that's true. Probably about 1,000 extra people, maybe. Long kickoff here, and a fair catch made inside the 5-yard line by returner Jeremiah Knight, a redshirt sophomore out of Jefferson, Ohio. And so Akron here is going to begin things from their own 25. Actually, a touchback on the kickoff there with Knight making the catch. Akron trying to answer. RedHawks has scored 14 unanswered points. Football game so far. Nelson Cano back on the field. He will play action handoff. Fire to the far side for a slant route, but it's blocked down by Bart Barati. Number 49 for the RedHawks. Defense was right there, and as soon as the ball left Cano Nelson's hand, Barati got two arms up and knocked it straight to the ground.
Yeah, and as soon as that ball came off Barati's hands, he was already frustrated with himself that he wasn't able to come down with that interception. That probably would have been a pick six for him. But that ball moving at really high speed just came out of Nelson's hand and had nowhere to go. And a second 10 here for the Zips.
Receivers to the right and one to the left here for Cato Nelson. Ball on their own 25 for a second and 10. Backfield empties out. Nowhere to go. Pocket collapsing for Nelson. He's in trouble and brought down. Cato Nelson inside his own 20-yard line to the 18. It's going to be a loss of 7 for the Zips. A 3rd and 17 about to come up. As Nelson that time had no options. Loss of 8 for a 3rd down here for the Zips. It's 17. Akron to the line with two receivers on either side. On a 3 on the play clock here for the Zips. Empty backfield, Nelson in trouble again. We'll just fire to the near sideline and almost intercepted there as a RedHawk was in the area. That was number 5, Emmanuel Ragumba. And we have a man down on the field here for Akron, and it might be Nelson Kaito. And they call intentional grounding on Nelson, the Akron quarterback. Doesn't really matter though, the drive pretty much over, 4th down inside their own 10-yard line, but Cato Nelson walking off the field a little gingerly, Luke. He was down for a long time after that last play and now seems to be limping a little bit. Oh, now we get another flag coming out as he walks off the field. Thrown by the umpire as Nelson was talking with the umpire trying to walk off the field, and it's probably not sportsmanlike conduct, said something that the umpire didn't like. Referee about to announce the call. It's an unsportsmanlike conduct foul against Cato Nelson, and they'll bring him half the distance to the goal. So Akron started the drive on their own 25-yard line, and now it's going to be 4th and 32 from their own 3.
Yeah, it really does a comedy of errors towards the end of that drive that really didn't get anything going. I mean, the Miami defensive line, credit to them, just really putting a lot of pressure on Cato Nelson, forced the intentional grounding to push them way back on that 3rd down. And Nelson, I think, really has to make an adjustment if he does return to this game. Obviously, the line not playing as well as they hoped he would, but really needing to kind of get that ball off quicker as he's just spending a lot of time looking, and the RedHawks are just eating him alive in the pocket right now. So they're going to punt. And
yeah, all the way back
feet are right back on the end zone
line. I know. Jonah Weil in that time. It's caught by Thomas at the 50. He will get ahead to about the 41. And great starting field position here for the RedHawks to begin this next offensive drive on a 9-yard punt return coming there from Maurice Thomas. So 5:37 to go in the second quarter. We'll get another media timeout. RedHawks lead at 17-3, trying to add them on to the Akron Zips. Miami football on RedHawk Radio. Patrick Geshan, Luke West Poley back with you here after the timeout on Red Hawk Radio with 5:37 to go in the second quarter. Appreciate you sticking through all of our earlier technical difficulties. And just to give you an idea of what the night has been like, Luke West Poley just dropped his notes over the ledge here at Yager Stadium and had to go into the stands and retrieve them. It's kind of the theme of tonight. 17-3, the RedHawks have been successful on the field. Gabbert on a first and 10, a pitch to the near side. Tyree Shelton will run it for the first down all the way outside at the 29-yard line of Akron. And the RedHawks here picking up some big gains. That was the story last week, Luke. The RedHawks on about every touchdown, it wasn't like a 1-yard rush in the end zone or a 2-yard rush or a 3-yard pass. It was 60-yard pass, 59-yard run, the big plays.
Yeah, you know, and I think that's just also how the RedHawks offense runs with that no huddle. They like to score, and they like to score quickly. And I think, you know, we've seen a little bit of a difference in that tonight. And I think, you know, as they get into bowl season and conference championship season, they're going to want to learn and teach their offense kind of how to chew up more clock.
Yep.
Because obviously they may need that when they're playing against some of the strongest opponents they play all season. And eating up clock's an important skill to have if you're up, really. Clock management is big, especially in those big games, late in those games. And the RedHawks kind of slowing things down here tonight a little bit, just trying to learn a new style of offense maybe that they haven't used as much over the past 10 weeks.
Gabbert has two receivers left and one to the right. On a second and 10 coming up from the Akron 29-yard line. They try to run it last play, but there was no gain. Gabbert a handoff. Bester up the left hash. Dances his way to the 23-yard line. And that'll be a pickup of 6 for the RedHawks to bring it to a 3rd and 4. Four receivers on the left here and a bunch formation, and Gabbert trying to screen pass it to the far side there, but Akron getting in the way of blocking it. Is a great read by Akron's number 31, the defensive back AJ Watts, who rushed forward as soon as the snap came off and blocked down the pass intended for the far side of the field. And Fourth and four for the Redhawks in their own 23, which means a 41-yard field goal attempt coming from Sam Sloman, who already made one earlier tonight for the Redhawks. His career long is 53, and Sloman's kick has the distance from the middle of the field, but it's no good. The Akron sideline likes that. That's going to give him some momentum as Sloman missed it wide. And that is just the fourth missed field goal out of 21 attempts now for Sam Sloman, who came into the game 16th in the nation and made field goals. And the Rocks turn it over on downs on the missed attempt with 3:50 to go in the second quarter on the Akron 23-yard line.
Yeah, really uncharacteristic miss there from Sloman. But as you mentioned, this could give the Zips some more momentum. Looks like Nelson is back in the game now. And so let's see if they've made any adjustments from the last drive as Nelson was eaten alive by that defensive line.
Back to the 15, a long pass to the far side of the field, and it is almost brought in but dropped at the last moment. Julian Hicks the target over there, but nice job by the Redhawks to get in there and break that up. The defender, number six, Travion Banks, as Hicks had a control of the ball but coming down, lost it. It'll be second and 10 for their own 23.
Yeah, Banks just gets his arm up into the hands of the receiver at the last.
And 3:10 to go here in the second. There'll be three receivers left and one to the right. Nelson empty backfield for Akron, sends a receiver to the far side of the field. That's Scipio. High snap, Nelson has to dodge the blitz. Now he's up the left side. Great athletic moves. Cato Nelson runs his way for a first down. Across the Akron 35-yard line to the 36. Cato Nelson was going to be tackled about three times on that rush. Luke dancing all over red jerseys, but picks up a first and 10 for Akron.
Yeah, really good athletic play there from Cato Nelson. Also, just great decision-making. He decides to step up in the pocket. He finds a hole. He's able to dodge a couple tackles, pick up the first down, and really just kind of pulling things together. He's kind of panicked a little bit early under some pressure, but really calm there, able to pick up five and a first down for the Zips.
Three receivers on the right, none on the left here. Nelson will get it with Brandon Lee in the backfield. The backfield empties out. Nelson is rolling to the far side. Will fire a pass there. It's brought in by Jeremiah Knight. And he is pushed out of bounds about 1 yard behind the line of scrimmage. Nelson scrambling that time, was able to regain the lost yardage from, he was standing all the way back, the 25-yard line, 10 yards behind the line of scrimmage, but Knight able to get them to within 1 yard behind it, so it's going to be a second and 11 from 35. With 1:40 to go here in the second. Three receivers right and one to the left. Cato Nelson, backfield empties out. He's here to pass, fires it near side, and it was in the feet of the intended target. That was number 25, Peter Hayes Patrick, who couldn't bend down and run sideways at the same time to bring in the catch. And a third and 11 coming up here for Akron from their own 35, as it was a wide open screen pass to the near side for Hayes Patrick, who doubles as a running back. Couldn't bring in the catch on his first pass attempt of the day, and so with 1:23 to go in the second, these Zips need 11 yards to continue the drive.
Yeah, and if the Redhawks can get a stop here, they still got three timeouts left, and you got to think with Maurice Thomas as your returner, maybe get some decent field position and have Sloman try another field goal, as I believe the Zips are going to burn a timeout here, and they will.
They will burn their second of the half with 1:23 to go in the first. 30-second timeout here for Akron. Well, the series between these two teams has been mostly one-sided. The Redhawks lead it all-time 18-9-1. 11-3-1 are the Redhawks in Oxford against the Zips. This is the 29th all-time meeting. The first time these two teams met was back in the year 1916. Last time these two teams met, October 6th, 2018. Redhawks winning that one up at Akron by a score of 41-17. The Zips still rebuilding, looking for MAC win number one of the season, and in general win number one of the season. Tom Arthur, new head coach in his first year, trying to rebuild that Akron program. Three receivers left to the right here, an empty backfield for Nelson on a 3rd and 11 out of the timeout. He's in trouble, pocket collapsing. Nelson runs it up the right side of the field, tripped up around the 45. And yet will not be enough. He's only about a yard short of the first down as the Redhawks too focused on the pass coverage there, and Nelson in trouble. It'll to get him within 1 yard. They're gonna go for it here on a 4th and 1 from their own 44. And we get a whistle, the Redhawks defense scrambling, and Chuck Martin may have just called a timeout. And they in fact have used their first timeout as Akron lining up inside their own territory, Luke, to go for this 4th down and 2 officially, but the Redhawks defense scrambling around there.
Yeah, and I'm kind of surprised that Chuck Martin didn't call this timeout a little bit earlier. They're gonna reset it to 101 here, but still taking 10 seconds off the clock here on this 4th and 2. Interested to see what the Zips are gonna do. As I seem to mention all the time on our broadcast, we sit right next to the away team's coaching box, and there was some fist slams on tables after the Redhawks called that timeout as they really wanted to get that snap off quick. They were going no huddle, and the referees wouldn't move out of the way as the ball hadn't been spotted yet. Miami called a timeout in that kind of interval. Now we'll see if they're going to go for it here, if they just tried to draw the Redhawks off. I don't see Nelson on the field right now.
Well, it could have been the attention. They maybe were trying to drive the Redhawks offside. I don't either, and the punter just ran onto the field. Keep an eye out for a fake, though.
Interesting formation here from the Zips.
And the punt is off from the right side and may have gotten blocked at the line. It goes out the far sideline. Not a very long punt. Out in about the 35-yard line there for Akron. And the Redhawks here are going to begin the drive on their own 33-yard line. That punt had a very weird ball flight direction to it. Went out of bounds right after being kicked almost.
Yeah, and that's kind of a mistake you can't really afford to have this late in the half. You now put the Redhawks within 30 yards of field goal range, and with how quick they can gain big chunks of yardage, that's something that you definitely don't want to do. They still have 2 timeouts left and almost a minute to work with to get about 20 yards, 30 yards or so. And a bit of frustration there from Akron after that punt.
Cabra on a 1st and 10, less than a minute to go in the first half, and it's a pass here, and up the near side of the field comes Jalen Besser with his first reception of the game. Redhawks know how to offense working here. They want to get some points on the board with 40 seconds to go in the first quarter. 2nd and 2 from their own 41. Gabbert, near side pass. Besser fell over. He tripped up while the ball was flying to him and couldn't bring in the catch. And now a 3rd and 2 coming up on the incompletion. The clock stopped with 34 seconds to go in the second quarter. And why not try to put points on the board? 17-3, the Redhawks lead them. Want a more comfortable lead at the half. Two receivers left and two to the right here. Besser is next to Gabbert in the backfield. Gabbert clapping twice. We'll get the snap. Rolls back here to the near side. A pass to the near side of the field. Andrew Homer made the catch, and they say he got both feet in. Right at the 50-yard line, Andrew Homer was sailing out of bounds but brought it in and got at least 1 foot in there to give the Redhawks the first down and a clock stoppage with 29 to go here in the second.
And there's going to be no review here. The Redhawks are just going to snap it.
Gabbert with an empty backfield looking near side of the field, and it is intercepted by Akron. Jack Sorensen, the intended target. It was tipped by his initial defender, and then coming in to grab the ball out of the air was Alex Ramart, number 12 for the Zips. The 6'3", 215 redshirt sophomore ends the Redhawks' hope of an offensive drive and more scoring on points on the board to end the quarter, and Akron's going to get it 1st and 10 from their own 31-yard line here as Sorensen nearly double-teamed there. Luke, the safety coming in to make the interception off the tip.
Yeah, and you can kind of see where Gabbert was going with that throw. Sorensen had a little bit of space on his defender, but it was a bit of a line drive throw, and Gabbert didn't try to go over the top with it. As a result, that pass got tipped by the corner who'd already gotten beat, and the Zips able to intercept this. Now with 24 seconds left and 1 timeout, not sure if they're going to do anything too crazy with this besides just run the ball.
Two receivers to right as Nelson's backfield empties out. He fires it to the far side of the field, but way out of bounds. The only man in the area there for Akron was number 25 there, running back Peter Hayes Patrick, who's also made some receptions today. 18 seconds to go now in the second. And the Zips will have it second and 10 from their own 31-yard line. Slowly getting to the line here with 18 on the play clock. Be interesting to see, Luke, how many fans stick around in the half. Or for the second half, rather, at halftime, because last week about 60% of the crowd left.
Yeah, this game a little bit closer, though, and the weather a little bit better, so I'm expecting probably more fans to stay, but still probably going to be some that will leave as the Zips run it here.
We would hope. Handoff at the left hash. Hayes Patrick that time getting to the 35-yard line. Pickup of about 5 on the rush for Akron. 5 seconds to go here in the first half, and Zips will not aim here to run another offensive play. The clock hits 0, and we're through 30 minutes of football here on a Wednesday night in Oxford. Miami 17, Akron 3, your halftime score. And Luke Westpola, your thoughts after 30 minutes of play?
Well, I think this was a slow start for both the teams, and we had some technical difficulties, a little bit difficult to focus on the game that we were announcing, and a bit of a slow start for the RedHawks offense. They got going, though, towards the end of that second half, and the Zips need to make some adjustments going forward, not really finishing off a whole ton of plays. RedHawks playing really well through contact right now, breaking a lot of tackles, so the Zips need to finish off plays, I think, here going into the second half. Also, just needed to get that ball out of the quarterback's hands quicker. Nelson has had faced all kinds of pressure. Wouldn't be surprised if we see a lot more screens and quick passes, which they were actually had a little bit of success on in the first half. So look to see that in the second half as Miami's up 14 here at the break.
RedHawks really ran away with the game against Bowling Green last week at the half, but this one pretty close. Just a 2-possession game between Miami and Akron. The Zips trying to play spoiler here against the RedHawks postseason hopes as we near the second half. Q&A with Ryan J, our usual hockey intermission segment. We're taking it to the gridiron for the final home game of the year. Coming up here at the half in just a few moments. Miami 17, Akron 3. Thanks for sticking with us through all the technical difficulties in that first half. Back in a moment, Miami football on RedHawk Radio. Back here at Yager Stadium, Oxford, Ohio, the Miami RedHawks 17, the Akron Zips 3 at the half. Q&A with Ryan J coming up here, usually our second intermission hockey segment, but this time taking it over to the football side of things. So, Ryan, what do you think of this football game here tonight in Wednesday night action?
Well, I got to tell you, it's cold. I'd rather be in an ice rink right now. I am cold. And
but isn't an ice rink a cold place?
It is, but, you know, it is much colder out here.
Okay.
But I got to tell you, I'm watching this this marching band ordeal right now, and I have no clue what shapes they're making on this field. What is that?
I'm trying to figure it out. They got four different groups of people playing.
It looks like gibberish.
Okay, but they're playing good music, they work very hard. Of course, the marching band practicing all kinds of days and nights throughout the week. So we have someone talking to us in the booth right now. Excuse us, we had someone talking to us in the booth up here. Okay, so talking about football coming up. Now, Luke West Poley goes to Talawanda High School, and he's got a big hockey game coming up tomorrow. Luke, tell us about that.
Yeah, so we got our season opener tomorrow night at the Goggin on the B-pad. We've been really looking forward to that for the past few months, playing the Miami club team. That's been a big rivalry between those teams that went back before the Miami team when it was called Butler County, then before then when it was called Baden, and that's really dated back a long time, so a big rivalry. So we're really excited and just hoping for the best. It's my first regular season high school game of my career, so hoping for good things.
Now, I got a couple questions for you, Luke. What position do you play?
I play defense.
You're a defenseman, right or left?
Because I'm 5'6 and 120 pounds.
Oh, yes. You got a little bit bigger to get.
Yeah. I gotta hit the gym, but I'll play whatever. I'll play whatever side. I just kind of do utility stuff.
Well, just slow down the game a little bit, pass the puck up very nicely, and gotta lay some body out there.
Lay some body, all right.
Lay some body.
Lay some body.
All right, so Ryan, a native of Chicago, tried Skyline Chili for the first time yesterday, and what'd you think about that?
Oh, it was amazing. It was amazing.
Okay, give more detail.
The way that the meat and the cheese kind of melt together to combine with the noodles,
yeah,
really pleasures my palate.
Okay, good.
So I'll say also shout out to the waitresses in Skyline though. They were pretty cool.
Okay, very good. All right, so Ryan, in this football game, Redhawks lead it by a score of 17-3 here, and hopefully the crowd sticks around for a lot of halftime, but what have you liked from the Redhawks play so far on the gridiron tonight?
I love how fast-paced it is. You know, a lot of big running plays, very long throws. They've just been moving up the field at a very fast pace, and it's been entertaining to watch.
All right, let's talk the hockey side of things here for Miami. Now that I have both of you here with us, Redhawks playing on the road this week at Omaha. Big NCHC series coming up for the Redhawks after a split last weekend against Minnesota Duluth. So a question for both of you here. What did you like out of the Redhawks play last weekend? What do you want to see out of the games against Omaha this week? And Ryan, you first.
I really liked how put together the Redhawks team. It seemed like they just had great chemistry, plays were clicking, great passes, and although we didn't get a lot of opportunities, when we did get an opportunity to score, we often capitalized. It was great to watch, and I hope that if they bring that into Omaha, where maybe not as strong as a team, and we could rack up a couple more goals and hopefully sweep them.
Luke?
Yeah, well, I think especially on Friday night, the game that I announced with you, Patrick, I think they just really played almost a complete game. You know, obviously, I don't think they played a full 60 minutes, but something that especially we've seen for the Redhawks in years past, during these years where they haven't been as successful, is just kind of these breakdowns where, you know, they'll have 5-10-minute stretches where, you know, they'll just give up all kinds of opportunities. You don't really see them get completely dominated, you know, like a Denver, you know, Soviet Union 80s style, you know, brand of hockey where they just get completely dominated on and, you know, possess the puck and everything just gets put on them. I think that really the reason they've been losing games in the years past was just because of just small breakdowns and, you know, little things that in 5-10 minutes would result in, you know, 2-3 goals and put themselves down. So I think that they really just held it together and just capitalized on their opportunities and just minimized
Duluth, and I think that they got a lot of confidence in, you know, getting a split with Duluth and moving forward into Omaha.
Three more series left for the Miami hockey team. Omaha, they go to UConn Thanksgiving weekend and then back home against St. Cloud State December 6th and 7th before a long break before their next game is December 30th against the Bowling Green Falcons up in Bowling Green. So about 11 minutes to go until the second half. Miami 17, Akron 3 here from Yager Stadium in Oxford, and we'll bring you the second half in just a moment here from Yager Stadium in Oxford coming up. You're listening to Miami Football on Red Hawk Radio. Stay with us. Second half action coming up in just a moment. Miami 17, Akron 3 as we're about to begin the second half of action here from Yager Stadium in Oxford, Ohio. Patrick Gish and Luke Westpoli back with you here. And Luke, what's your mentality going into this second half if you're the Miami RedHawks?
Well, I think that you just got to get back to what we saw kind of intermittently throughout that first half, which was big plays and just a lot of pass rush, a lot of pressure on Cato Nelson. They got a lot of pressure on him early in the first half and kind of forced him to make some decisions he didn't want to make. He had to tuck that ball and just take sacks a lot on the defensive side. On the offensive side, I think they just got to continue to run the ball well. Really had some explosive runs, especially from Davian Johnson and Jalen Bester. They've both had themselves very good first halves. And, you know, the RedHawks up here, you know, you want to extend this lead out right now because it's only just two scores, and maybe get some momentum back on your side, as kind of they lost a little bit of that after that missed field goal towards the end of the second half. And if you're Akron, you're still in this game, and you need to come up with a big stop here, though. This is probably one of the biggest drives of the game to this point, as Miami's going to receive the kickoff to open the second half.
Sips here will kick left to right across your radio to begin half number two. As it's going to be their kicker number 47, Jerry Fitchin, to kick off here for Akron. The RedHawks back to get it. Maurice Thomas finds a lane up the left side, and he's tackled down at the 31-yard line. Broke through about five tackles there to get taken down across the 30, and Brett Gabbert and company out there with the RedHawks up by 14 in this one to begin the next drive. This Miami here trying to put some points on the board. They didn't really end that first half in the best of light. An interception on their final drive. Gabbert with a man to his left. He has three receivers right and one to the left. And he's back to pass here with an empty backfield over the middle. Gabbert trying to go up the left hash of the field, and it was in and out of the hands of Jack Sorensen to create a second and 10 from the 32-yard line.
That was a good throw by Gabbert down the middle on the quick slant, about 15 yards down the field, right near the breadbasket of Sorensen, and he just wasn't able to come down with that one.
Two receivers right and one to the left for the RedHawks. Handoff here up the right side of the field. Bester tackled down after a gain of one on the second down 10 rush. Jalen Bester has been one of the biggest surprises of the RedHawks season so far. Was really never meant to be a huge impact player on the running side of things, but after having some big performances, especially in the home game against Buffalo, they gave the ball to Bester a lot in that game, and all of a sudden he now leads the RedHawks in rush yards this year. 3rd and 9 from their own 33. Two receivers left, one to the right. Gabbert drops back to pass, got hit hard, but got a throw off, and it's incomplete for Miami. The intended target, Andrew Homer, the tight end over the middle, as Gabbert got that one off just in time before three white jerseys collapsed in on him. And the ball there dropped at the 45-yard line by Homer. 4th and 9 for the RedHawks from their own 33. They're going to go 3 and out on drive number one of the second half.
And a big momentum switch there for the Zips defense, as they were able to, especially on that last play, get pressure on Gabbert, force him to make a throw down the middle. The RedHawks going to go 3 and out, aided by some drops there. The Zips defense was on that drive. But they're going to get the ball back here and get a chance to put 7 on the board.
Kyle Kramer's punt is going to go out of bounds the far side. We have a flag coming in from an official all the way down near the returner. It's standing right now at the Akron 20-yard line, the flag is. As the Kramer punt sailed out the far side of the field. And we will get a look here at what the penalty is all about. It's going to be holding on Akron after that return.
That was a bit of an awkward flag throw. Is that flag was thrown about 10 yards behind the Akron returner, and that was nowhere near anyone, really. So not quite sure where that
penalty happen.
Well, that one official is all the way down at the Akron end zone. He ran up to where the ball was punted to mark where it went out of bounds, and he threw the flag running from the goal line to around the 30-yard line. He landed the flag at the 20. So just a weird position for an official to make that call in.
And now the sticks are going to move back, and the Zips offense is also going to move back to around the 30-yard line as they didn't account for the penalty on the initial spot. So they'll begin from their own 30 here.
Two receivers right and one to the left. Cato Nelson and company back out there here for Akron. Hands it off and up the left hash. A run by Peter Hayes Patrick. He is going to pick up 4 yards. Three officially on the rush for Peter Hayes Patrick. Second and 7 coming up from the Akron 33. And the Zips here, Luke, the pass game is their bread and butter of the offense, but last half really wasn't working well, and so far early on in this second, they're really trying to get the run game going.
Yeah, Nelson not having a lot of confidence right now. His wide receivers, I thought, did a pretty good job of burning the corners for Miami, but just so much pressure on him, he really wasn't able to make any good throws for most of the first half.
Pass to the far side on a slant route that time, Timothy Scipio. Who's the intended target, but it was incomplete, and now we have a 3rd down and 7 coming up from their own 33. Akron here lines up. They got 2 receivers left and 1 to the right. Scipio, a man to his right in the backfield for Akron. And Nelson back to pass. He's going to roll to the far side of the field. Davian Johnson got the ball free on a tackle of Nelson. It went out the far sideline. And it was Davian Johnson running down to the far side of the field to knock it out of bounds near the 25. And it's going to be a 4th and 20 coming up for Akron from their own 25-yard line.
And the RedHawks respond there after a bit of a slow offensive drive to get this second half started. Defense comes up with a stop, and they do it with an exclamation mark as they put Akron 5 yards behind their original spot.
Long punt here for the Zips, brought in by Maurice Thomas. He makes a fair catch down at the Miami 38-yard line. And that is where the RedHawks here are going to begin the drive after this media timeout. 12:37 to go in the third quarter. It's Miami 17, Akron 3. As we're back in a moment here, Miami football on RedHawk Radio.
Thank you.
12:37 to go here in the third quarter from Oxford. Miami 17, Akron 3, your score. As the ball here will be in the Redhawks' hands, they'll have it first and 10 from their own 37-yard line to begin the next drive. Waiting for the media timeout to be over from our friends at ESPNU. Redhawks had two touchdowns in the first half, and a field goal was their first score of the game from Sam Sloman. Sloman also missed a field goal in the first half, and so where we are now, 17-3, Redhawks lead it. Two receivers to the left, one to the right here for Gabbert in a pistol formation. We'll hand off to the man behind him. That's Tyree Shelton trying to shove his way up the right side of the line. Gets to the 41-yard line for a pickup of about 5. So it'll be a 2nd and 6 officially coming up from the 41-yard line. Rucks, you're kind of taking their time a little bit in this half. Two receivers right, one to the left. Gabbert with a pocket collapsing in trouble. He's going to make a spin move trying to go to the near side of the field. Gabbert almost taken down for a loss in the play, but regains control and is down at the 41-yard line. No gain on the play for Brett Gabbert. Sets up a 3rd and 6 from the 41.
Yeah, calm play there by Gabbert. He had a lineman on him. It was a Zips lineman on his shoe. He was able to kind of shake him off his leg and spun his way back to the line of scrimmage for no gain, and now a manageable third down here for the Redhawks.
Two receivers right and one to the left for Gabbert in the pistol formation. The man behind him, Jalen Bester, who now moves to Gabbert's right. A little bit in front of him in the backfield. Gabbert claps once, looks far side of the field, and it's a catch. Completion over there on the far side. Jack Sorensen bringing it in. They're now in Zips territory down to the 48-yard line. 11:09 to go in the third. 17-3, your score.
Yeah, the Zips are in zone coverage there. Only had one guy on that far side of the field. The Redhawks had two wide receivers going that way. They split and went opposite ways, and when the corner followed one way, Gabbert threw the other in a big gain for the Redhawks.
Gabbert play action fake, looking for a long pass, rolls far side, decides to keep it to the 45, dodges a tackle out of bounds at the 43-yard line. And Brett Gabbert on the keep there is going to set up a very manageable 2nd down and middle distance here for the Redhawks, make it something out of nothing there. Andrew Homer, the tight end, will come in for Miami. They're going to bring in Davia Johnson as well. Bester's going to come out for the Redhawks. Two receivers left, one to the right. Gabbert claps once. Now glances at the sideline with 12 on the play clock. Backing it here from the gun to get the snap. Hands off. Johnson behind him trying to charge through about 11 bodies that are all piled up in a bunch at the line. He got pushed toward his right, and Damian Johnson will pick up no gain on the rush to make it a 3rd and 6 from the Akron 44. .9:45 to go in this third quarter. Two receivers right and one to the left. Gabbert with a man to his left in the backfield. That's Damian Johnson. He clapped once. Glances back to the sideline. The typical pattern all year we've seen, Luke. That time two glances to the sideline. Now the snap on the 2nd clap. Gabbert fires a near side, but not in the area of anybody. Jalen Walker and another wide receiver for the Redhawks. Number 19, James May, was in the area as well, but the pass was about 10 yards behind both of them, and it'll be a...
Here's a flag down, though.
Okay.
The flag was thrown kind of in the area of where Gabbert was throwing that ball. Both of his wide receivers went nowhere near where he thought they were going. Just a miscommunication there. Not sure who this penalty is going to be on. We're going to get the call here.
Offense. two penalties on Miami. The first one was declined. The second one, an intentional grounding on Gabbert and company, and it'll create a 4th and 14 out of that. Miami's going to have to send the punting unit on. Still up 17-3 with 9:22 to go in the third quarter. As the punt unit huddles up here with 17 on the play clock, breaks it up, and Kyle Kramer waits for another punt. The snap on the ground, has to pick it up, still gets the kickoff though. End over end, and it's caught and trying to return it up the far side of the field is Akron's number 82. That's Jeremiah Knight on another punt return. Got tackled down after a gain of about 8 on the punt return for Jeremiah Knight. With 9:09 to go here in the third quarter, and we will get yet another timeout. Miami 17, Akron 3. Zips get the ball back when we return. Miami football on Red Hawk Radio. To go here in the third quarter. Patrick Geshan, Luke West-Poley back with you here in what may be our final football game of the year on Red Hawk Radio. Let's see where the bowl game is. Maybe go to that.
Hopefully not in Texas or Florida or somewhere of that nature.
I don't think the travel budget covers that far.
We aren't flying.
Unless the viewers want to pay. Handoff here for Akron on a 1st and 10. They're going to a man who hasn't rushed yet tonight, number 7, Brandon Lee out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Gains 2 on a rush up the middle, 2nd and 8 from the 21 with 8:43 to go here in the third quarter. Next broadcast coming your way on Red Hawk Radio, November 28th, Friday after Thanksgiving, hockey against UConn.
From UConn.
Long pass here for Nelson. He threw it to the far side, but it's incomplete. We got some shoving after the play and some players coming in. The defender that time for the Redhawks was Emmanuel Ragumba. And I never quite got to see who the wide receiver was for Akron. I think it was number 7, Brandon Lee. And when Lee was unable to make the catch because Ragumba made a clean defensive play, Lee gave him a shove. So the referee's huddling here. There's no flags on the field right now. And I believe they're not even going to throw one.
Yeah, this surprises me a little bit here. I think Ragumba got a little bit violent after that ball was already batted away. He picked up the receiver and kind of slammed him on the ground, and then Lee gave him a shove back, and he fell over. I'm not sure if there was any acting involved in that, as we didn't really see it. They're going to be a stoppage here. They're going to reset the clock. But surprised that there weren't offsetting penalties or something of that sort on that play. But nonetheless, now it's a 3rd and 8 for the Zips. They haven't had really anything going for them on offense too much in this game, and especially here early in the second half. And they're going to go with 5 wide receivers here, so taking a risk, going to try and move the ball downfield on 3rd down.
3 on the right and 2 on the left. And Cato Nelson has an empty backfield for the Akron Zips. Man of motion runs across the field and joins Nelson in the backfield. And then he becomes a receiver. Nelson is going to keep it here with no options on a 3rd and 8. And he's tackled down to the 25-yard line. And that's 4 yards short of the 1st down. Nelson trying to go up the far side of the field there, but couldn't find an opening big enough. And we'll see what they do here with a 4th and 4 from their own 25. The punt team coming on with 8:10 to go in the third quarter, a 17-3 game.
Yeah, not really sure when the game's this close you can really risk it. I mean, you're basically giving the RedHawks points here if you don't get this 4th down, and especially with the way your offense has been performing. Might just want to punt this one away and regroup here.
Long punt here. It's coming for Akron as Maurice Thomas will make a fair catch back at the 33-yard line. Jonah Weiland, another pretty decent punt for the Zips. And Russell begin the next offensive drive here from their own 32 with 7:45 to go in the third quarter. Miami 17, Akron 3, another timeout from Oxford in a pretty close game. Zips trying to get their first one of the year over the Miami RedHawks, but Miami trying to shut them down and increase their chances of going to a bowl game. It's Miami football on RedHawk Radio. Two receivers right and one to the left here for Brett Gabbert out of the timeout, who takes a snap. A play action fake to Tyree Shelton. A bullet over the middle there was tipped, and a flag comes in late. Jack Sorensen, the intended receiver. And the defender that time for Akron was Alvin Davis Jr. over the middle. Sorensen on the ground when the pass came toward him. And I didn't look quick enough to see if that could have been a penalty, but I believe that's what they called. It's going to be holding here against Akron, and on a what was going to be a second and 10 coming up. Brock's going to get another first down here coming from their own 42. With 7:39 to go here in the third quarter, Miami 17, Akron 3. There's two receivers right and one to the left. Yager has a man next to him on each side in the backfield. Bester on his left, Tyree Shelton on his right. Claps twice, hands it off. Bester, never mind. A keep there for Brett Gabbert, and he was going to get swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain. If Bester got that handoff, he would have had a pretty good hole, but instead Gabbert, the keep, got swallowed up very early in the rush.
Yeah, Bester probably ran without the ball 20 yards downfield, completely untouched, maybe partially because he didn't have the ball. And, you know, you can't hit a guy who's not involved in the play like that, but Gabbert just had absolutely nothing. Not sure if that was an option, and he decided to pull if that was a designed run. But either way, really nothing there on the run for Gabbert.
7 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Three receivers right in a bunch formation. A handoff to Tyree Shelton up the right side of the field over the 45-yard line for Miami. And he will pick up three there to make it a third down and 7 from their own 45.
Well, that time they would have been better off switching, I think. If Gabbert kept that one, I think he would have had a lot of room around the other side. So just Akron switching things up here on the Redhawks.
Gabbert back to pass, rolls near side of the field. It's a catch there for Sorensen. And he's still trying to push his way forward all the way down to the 36-yard line of Akron. Jack Sorensen that time with a catch to the near side of the field. Plenty to give the Redhawks a first to 10.
Yeah, great catch there by Sorensen. He's able to play through some contact. He gets after he catches it, has a little bit of room to work with, wiggles his way through a couple defenders, gains about an extra 5 yards or so. So the Redhawks now in the 36, putting together a pretty promising drive here.
Two receivers right, one to the left here for Gabbert. A man on either side of the backfield. This time it's a handoff. Bester and Reuben horizontally to the far side. Got eaten up at the 40. And it'll be a second and 4 here on a gain of 6, or a loss rather of about 4 for Jalen Bester. The scoreboard was not correct here at Yager Stadium. He was running 90-degree angle to his right, and it's going to be instead a second down and about 15 coming up for the Redhawks from the Akron 40-yard line. Two receivers left and one to the right. Gabbert here with a man to his left in the backfield. It's Tyree Shelton as Homer runs across the line. Gabbert with a pass to your side. Shelton the catch, cross the 40 to the 35, and he got upended kind of awkwardly there. His feet got stuck under him getting tackled. Shelton pops right back up. But now it's going to be a third down and 10 coming up for the Redhawks, and that short run by Tyree Shelton.
Yeah, Shelton was able to get a little bit of yardage. And yardage from here would tie a career-long attempt for Sloman, who's already missed a field goal today. So the Redhawks probably trying to get at least a little bit more yardage, but actually probably even more wanting to put 7 on the board. So we'll see how they play this third down here.
Two receivers left and two to the right for Gabbert. Looks far side, gets hit immediately, and it's intercepted by Akron, and they are gone down the far side of the field. It's number 40, John Lako. A pick 6 for the Zips, and they're within one score here with 4:29 to go in the third quarter. Miami 17, Akron 9. It was bobbled around in the hands of John Lako, the linebacker, and he took it for about a 60-yard interception return for the touchdown, and the Akron Zips are right back in this one. We got a ball game from Oxford.
And this is just an all-around fantastic play from everybody on the Akron Zips defense. I mean, it all starts with this defensive line. They swarmed on Gabbert. He had to force this throw, did not want to make it over the middle. He got hit as he threw that, affected the trajectory right down the middle, right into the hands of the Akron defender, and as soon as he caught that, he was gone. He had blockers, he had speed, no Miami players back. Akron with a huge play on defense, a pick 6, and a big momentum swing for the Zips now late in the third quarter.
And walking back here for the PAT for Akron is Corey Smigel. Ball down the 10-yard line, he will kick it through the uprights for the PAT. And the Akron Zips are within 7, just like that. Seemed like the Redhawks were charging downfield and might score another touchdown, but Didn't take long for the Zips to climb right back into it. There's a touchdown for the Zips. John Lacko, first interception of the year, a 64-yard return. And your score here is 17-10, Miami on top. We'll be back in a moment. It's Miami football on Red Hawk Radio.
Don't sweat the technique. Don't sweat the technique. Let's trace the hits and check the file. Let's see who bit the dot tech the style. I flip the script so it can't get filed. At least not now, it'll take a while. I change the pace to complete the beat. I drop the bass to MCs get weak. For every road they trace is a scar they keep. Cause when I speak, they freak to sweat the technique. I made my debut in 86 with a melody and a president's mix. And now I stay on target and refuse to miss. And I still make hits for beats. Parties close.
4:29 to go, third quarter, Miami 17, Akron 10. The Zips about to kick off after the interception. And Luke, that changes the whole complete picture of the second half, that last play by John Lacko.
Absolutely, a huge play for the Akron defense and a big momentum shifter. I mean, they were all over the place, you know, celebrating that pick six. And really just a big momentum shifter now within one touchdown. Good thing for the Redhawks, though, is they're able to get this ball right back. We'll be able to see how Gabbert responds. But a big play for the Zips. And they're really, really excited now that they got a shot to win this game within seven.
Maurice Thomas will return the kick from inside his own end zone and will not be able to reach the 20. He's down to the 17. Under a tackle there by Akron's number 37, Jerome Cooper. So with 4:24 to go here in the third quarter, Redhawks are going to go against the Akron defense that has all the momentum in this game right now.
Yeah, Chuck Martin is not happy at all right now, just kind of pacing the sideline by himself, just kind of saying some words into his headset. And haven't seen him as fiery tonight as maybe we've seen in past games. But they do have the lead. Obviously, if Akron's able to pull this game into a tie, we may see the Chuck Martin that we've seen all year.
The receiver's right one to the left. Gabbert will hand off, and up the middle, it's Tyree Shelton. He picked up about 4 or 5 on the rush. 5 officially to make it 2nd and 5 from the 23-yard line. Rocks will try to get the no-huddle offense going here in an effort to climb back into this one. 2 receivers right, 1 to the left. Gabbert clapping twice. And looks to the sideline here for a call. Now he will grab it. And the handoff to Tyree Shelton. Broke 1 tackle. Now up past the 30 to the 35. Tackle down at the Miami 37-yard line. And Tyree Shelton gets plenty for a first down for the Redhawks. He'll move the chains with 3:45 to go in the third.
And he's done it all night, really just kind of bouncing off the defenders, not letting them take hold of him. We're going to get a timeout on the field for an injury, but Shelton's been really good tonight and just bouncing off the defenders, really shedding tackles and, you know, getting some extra yards after contact. I've, you know, said that word a lot tonight. It's really been all across the board for the Redhawks, really, and, you know, in terms of wide receivers, tight ends, and even, you know, Gabbert doing it for the Redhawks. So really an all-around effort. And just playing through contact for the Redhawks. And as a result, they've had some pretty good success on the offensive side of the ball. But this is a very, very, very big drive as they, you don't want to say they need the score, but it is very, very, very important that they get at least 3 points on this drive to extend this back out to at least a 2-possession game, because Akron has a lot of momentum. And you got to think right now that this might be their best shot, this next drive coming up for Akron, to score a touchdown on offense all game.
13 yards on the pickup there for Tyree Shelton on the last rush. Injured Akron player walking off the field on his own power. That's Alex Ramart, who's made some big plays defensively for the Zips today. Ball's going to be on the right hash here for the Redhawks. A 1st and 10 from their own 37-yard line. The clock stopped with 3:39 to go in the third quarter. And Miami leading this one by 7. 17-10, your score. 2 receivers left, 1 on the right here for Gabbert. He's got a man to his right in the backfield. 1 clap and a glance to the sideline on the near side. Walks it up and then back to the gun here with Bester to his right. It is a handoff up the near side of the field. Bestier breaks through one tackle, tripped up near the 45. They'll give him the 43-yard line of Miami, and so Jalen Bestier on a pickup there of about 6 yards to make it a second and four from the Red Hawk 43. Receiver on the other side for Gabbard, hands it off. Bestier charging his way up the middle, got to the 45, maybe the 46, still not enough for the first down on a second and four rush. He'll have two more for the first down here. .245 to go in the third quarter. Clock is moving. Gabbard takes the snap. Will rush it up the far side of the field, and he will get the first down. Originally an option play there, looking to hand off to the running back Bestier, but instead Gabbard charges forward for a gain of four, and the Redhawks pick up a clutch first down there.
Yeah, and I really like this approach from the Redhawks. Really, they don't need big plays. They don't need big plays to take back the momentum. They don't need a huge rush of 30-plus yards. Really just being methodical, getting those short runs in, just short gains, and just running plays over and over and over again to wear down this Akron defense.
Two receivers right and one to the left. Gabbard with another clap. Hands it off. Davian Johnson finds a hole up the middle. And he's tackled over the middle by the safeties. Gets all the way down to the Akron 39-yard line. 34-yard line, excuse me. And a pickup there of 14 for Davian Johnson. Will give the Redhawks a first and 10 here. The no-huddle offense continuing. Gabbard was going to throw to the far side. Johnson has plenty of room on a screen pass. Down to the 15. He's pushed out of bounds near the 14-yard line. As a huge mishap there in the coverage for Akron. Johnson was lined up in the backfield next to Gabbard. He extended all the way to a screen pass reach for Brett Gabbard to pass to on the far side, and Davian Johnson was gone for a big pickup there. The Redhawks inside the 10 for a first and goal from the 9, actually. Hand off to Johnson up the middle. He reaches the right hash and is pulled down for a gain of probably one or two, if that. Actually, no gain there for Johnson. And it'll be a second and goal coming up for Miami. Inside 2 minutes to go now in the third quarter. 1:15 left. And the Redhawks here are going to wait for some personnel to come on the field before the next snap. Receiver on either side here. Gabbard from the gun is going to take the snap. Hands it off to the man behind him. That's Bestier up the right side. Reaches the 5-yard line. And it's going to be third and goal from the 5 coming up for Miami with 48 seconds to go in the third quarter. More personnel changes coming up here for the Redhawks, who are looking to add more to the lead after the Akron pick six. Two receivers left, one to the right here for Gabbard. Man behind him. In the backfield appears to be Tyrese Shelton. Play action with Shelton. Gabbard over the middle of the end zone. Looking there for a homer. It was incomplete. He fell down backwards, and there is going to be no flags. It appeared to be contact before that pass came in. Homer fell over, could not have brought it in, and the Redhawks are off the field on a third and goal, and it's going to be fourth and goal from the 5. So a 23-yarder coming from Sloman from the right hash. A 23-yard field goal here for Sam Sloman. One for two on the night, made it from 44. This one, 23-yard chip shot is through. The Miami Redhawks get a drive here late in the third quarter that produces 3 points. They extend the lead to 10, 20-10 your score with 14 seconds to go in the third quarter.
Yeah, the Redhawks probably disappointed they weren't able to get 7 off of that drive as they were able to get inside the 10 on a nice catch and run by Davian Johnson, who had all kinds of room on that play, was able to get himself down to about the 8 or 9 yard line, but the Redhawks weren't able to get much beyond that. But they will extend this lead back out to 2 scores. But now we'll see how the Akron offense comes out after their defense came up with that big play in the pick six. Akron offense hasn't had a whole lot of momentum going for them thus far tonight. You have to score an offensive touchdown But they got a lot of momentum right now and looking to do it here on this next drive.
We'll need the defense to work here. Sam Sloman will kick off from the Miami 35-yard line near hash of the field. Redhawks lead up by a score of 20-10 over the Akron Zips in this third quarter. Sloman with a long kick from the right foot. It'll be another touchback here for Sam Sloman out the near side of the field past their returner, Jeremiah Knight. Sam Sloman coming into this game, 53 kickoffs on the year, 38 of them for touchbacks. That's 71.6%. So you know the strategy coming in as an opposing team that Sloman is not going to try to get you to return it.
Absolutely, and that's, you know, especially big to have when you have a kicker with the leg power to just kick that ball at the back of the end zone, because you just have the, you know, ability to, you know, you're facing a team with a dangerous returner, just kick that ball out the back of the end zone. We've seen teams with not as strong-legged kickers in years past, you know, take kicking out of bounds penalties, which, you know, really gives good field position. So the Redhawks not having to do that, it's a big luxury.
Nelson scrambling a throw to the far side of the field and plenty of open space. And I wouldn't be surprised to get an intentional grounding penalty here as Cato Nelson will create a second and 10. They're not going to throw a flag thinking a receiver was in the area, but Nelson held on the ball past the snap for a good 10 seconds and then fired an errant pass to the far side in open space of the football field. 5 seconds to go in the third quarter. We'll probably get one more snap in. Second and 10 for Akron from their own 25. One receiver left, three on the right here for Cato Nelson. He's got a man to his left in the backfield. Nelson back to pass, slant route to the near side, and it's a catch brought in there at the end of the third quarter for Akron by their wide receiver number 5, Nate Stewart, who will bring in his second reception of the day, and that will end the festivities here in quarter number 3. Miami 20, Akron 10. It's certainly a ball game with Wednesday night action from Yager Stadium. Miami football on Red Hawk Radio. A fresh quarter about to get underway here from Yager Stadium in Oxford, waiting for the television media timeout to get underway, or to finish. As Cato Nelson back to pass on a first and 10 for Akron, decides to run it past the line of scrimmage and slide down near the 40-yard line. Gain of 3 on the keep there for Cato Nelson, who does a pretty good job, Luke, when not having any options to pass, and a defense that likes to pass the ball a lot, does a pretty good job keeping it by himself and just running the ball.
Yeah, you mentioned he had 0 rushing yards last week, and this week he's, you know, kind of turned things around a little bit, especially in the second half, just when the pocket's collapsing, able to, you know, remain calm and just kind of move forward with the ball, tuck it and run, and get some yardage out of it.
Empty backfield here on a 2nd and 7, a pass over the middle, and it's a catch there, and still with more room out of bounds, the far sideline, the 45-yard line is Jeremiah Knight, their returner, who made the catch at the 50 and got his way through for 5 extra yards, good enough for a first down, and Akron still not done yet early on in this fourth quarter. 2 receivers left and 1 to the right. As Cato Nelson here is going to keep, found a break up the left side of the line, and it takes Sterling Weatherford to bring him down all the way at the 35-yard line. So Akron here with a gain of 9 on that last rush by Cato Nelson, really moving it well.
Yeah, Nelson with a Michael Vick-esque run there. He gave kind of a scissor kick juke type move to freeze one of the Redhawks defenders, was able to get a couple yards out of it, and he's been pretty good rushing so far on this drive, and they're driving now into Miami territory.
2 receivers right, 1 to the left. Play action fake for Nelson. He's back to pass at the 40, fires a bullet to the end zone, and it's caught for a touchdown. The Redhawks completely lost, I believe, Timothy Scipio in coverage. A flag is down inside the end zone, so hold on for a second. But Scipio is almost cherry picking back in the end zone to make the catch, as the Redhawks completely forgot about him. And a bullet to the end zone from Nelson, caught by Scipio for a touchdown. We'll have to see what the penalty is about. Call coming up. It's an unsportsmanlike conduct call on Akron. And the touchdown's gonna count, but penalty will be enforced here on the kickoff, but Luke, Scipio completely lost in coverage there.
Absolutely, yeah. Regrumbeg had to come all the way across the field. He was guarding another Akron player downfield. They went with a kind of double post on each side of the field, and Regrumbeg on the far side had to come all the way over to the near side, and I thought this might be a targeting foul on him because he absolutely laid out the receiver that caught that ball for Akron, but he was wide open until that ball reached his hands. He was able to come down with it. Regrumbeg flattened him, but he's able to keep hold of the ball. The extra point was good. And now Akron within a field goal here, and we really have a good game going for us here in the fourth quarter.
PAT was put through by Corey Smigel, the 5'8", 150 redshirt freshman of North Royalton, Ohio, who remains perfect on the season. And now the Zips are within 3 of Miami. 20-17, the Redhawks lead it early in the fourth quarter. Here from Oxford, it's Miami football on Red Hawk Radio.
sweat the technique. Don't sweat the technique. Let's trace the hits and check the file. Let's see who bit the dot tech.
13-17 to go in the fourth quarter here from Oxford. Miami 20, Akron 17 after the last touchdown producing drive from the Zips. The Nelson Cato pass down to Timothy Scipio for a 34-yard reception on an error by the RedHawks defense. And Luke, we got a ball game tonight.
Absolutely. The Zips really keeping this one close and just making sure the RedHawks just have a reason to play here down the stretch. The Zips within 3 points now. Interesting return for the RedHawks. They had nobody back. They're going to return this from the 10.
Thomas will pick up the loose ball. He was on the far side of the field. The ball came to the near side, and Thomas tackled down after just getting past the 20. And we're all the way up on the other side of the field from the Akron sideline, Luke, but you can feel the intensity and the momentum from the Zips right now as their sideline just really enthusiastic, jumping around into this game. The RedHawks just kind of quiet, standing there.
Yeah, you know, they're really enthusiastic. They want to get a win here on the road. And this is probably one of the closer games they've played in a while. And so, you know, it's always exciting when you're in a game, even though they're losing right now, they feel they have a chance to win. And that's always just an extra boost of energy, especially when you're just hunting for that first win.
Two receivers left, one to the right. Gabbard will hand off to Bester on the first play of the drive. And Bester only gains one on the rush. Try to go up the left hash that time. Jalen Bester tonight, now with just 105 rush yards. Well, I should say just 105 rush yards because he's had a lot of big plays and came into this game with 436 on the season. It's now well over the 500 mark. Should give justice to that, but in the second half for Bester, it just hasn't been his night in terms of running in the latter 30 minutes of this game. Two receivers right and one to the left. Gabbard claps twice with a snap. Another try to Bester on the handoff, and he's pushed back again. It's going to be a loss for the Miami RedHawks. The Akron sideline, you can probably hear, is going crazy right now. Their defense coming up with some huge stops here, and the RedHawks pinned to a 3rd and 8 from their own 26 and could go 3 and out on this drive early in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, really surprised we haven't seen any throws yet from Gabbard on this drive. Now, you know, pretty much have to throw here, you'd think. Maybe not, you know, you don't exactly know what's on Chuck Martin's mind, but 3rd and long here, we'll see what they do.
Receiver on the left, two receivers right here for Gabbard. Claps once, snap back, firing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Sorensen in the intended target, but he was hit down by the defender. That was number 29, Jalen Hooks in coverage for Akron, who completely knocked Sorensen out of contention for making the pass. No flags on the play, 3 and out for Miami on the drive with 11:42 to go in the fourth.
Akron is just rolling all over this RedHawks team right now. There, you can, as you already mentioned, you can just feel the energy coming from their sideline after every play. I mean, this feels like, you know, they're making their own student section here on that far side with all those players on the sideline.
Punt here for Kyle Kramer is low and not very far. It's going to take a bounce in front of Jeremiah Knight, the returner, and it took a really good RedHawks bounce about 10 yards back. Miami's going to pick it up at the 22. That ball initially hit the ground at the RedHawks 35-yard line but went back 13 yards after Knight decided not to touch it. We'll get another timeout coming up here with 11:31 to go in the fourth quarter. Miami 20, Akron 17. Zips trying to come back and take this one for win number one of the season. Miami football on Red Hawk Radio from Oxford. 11:31 to go in the fourth quarter. We got a football game now from Oxford. RedHawks 20, Akron 17. The Zips with all the momentum right now, and they're beginning another drive, this time from their own 22-yard line. It's Cato and Elson and company back out there for the Zips. Trying to take the lead for the first time today, and they have a shot to do it on this offensive sequence. Empty backfield for Nelson, a pass on first down, gets through the defenders at the line at the 25, now to the 30, that's where he's tackled down. Gatto Nelson, another great keep when there's no options to pass to downfield, picks up 7 to create a 2nd and 3.
Yeah, we mentioned the athleticism of him multiple times tonight. He's just been dodging defenders and just running through tackles all over the place today. Really been kind of a risky runner. You know, we've only seen him slide once. He's just going headfirst into those battles and getting the extra yards for the Zips.
RedHawks lead up by 3. 2nd and 3 from the 29 for Akron. A pass to the far side and too easy there. Brought in by Julian Hicks for the Zips. He ran a little route to the outside there and was able to bring in the catch undefended. And a gain of 6 here for the Zips. Will create a 1st and 10. Two receivers left and one to the right. Nelson fires it far side. It's a catch as running out of bounds there for a gain of about 3. Picking it up was Julian Hicks. Second and 8 coming up from the 37 with 10:15 to go in the fourth quarter. Clock is moving here, and the Zips really looking to add more to the plot twist of this game. Look like the RedHawks are going to run away with it at the half. Nelson in trouble at the line, trying to back up, and he is taken down. The RedHawks finally get to him that time. Cato Nelson now sacked for the 7th time today. And this is another time he can't really escape. The RedHawks there defensively, and it's going to be a 3rd and 13 and a loss of 5 all the way back at their own 32.
Yeah, Nelson's lucky he was able to hold on to the ball there. He was just kind of slipping and sliding all over the turf as that pocket collapsed in on him, didn't know where to go, was turning heads all over the place and kind of exposed the ball a little bit. But he was able to keep possession and just go down with it, so they'll keep possession here and go down now for a 3rd down and long.
Two receivers on either side. Nelson is back to pass. Looking near side of the field. A bullet, and it's brought in, but not enough for the 1st down. Great catch there. Going against Travion Banks, brought in by Timothy Scipio, who also had the touchdown pass in this quarter for Akron. It's going to be 4th and 4. He was 4 yards shy. The 1st down near side of the field. And the Zips are going to bring on the punt unit on their own 41-yard line here with 8:52 to go and counting in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, disappointing drive end there for the Zips is what looked like it had a lot of promise. But after that sack, they just weren't quite able to recover, and they're going to have to punt here.
Punt off the right foot of Jonah Weiland. Thomas back at the 20 will make the fair catch for the RedHawks. And that's where they're going to begin their next drive with 8:35 to go in the fourth quarter, and the RedHawks leading it by 3. And we will get a timeout, I believe, out of this. So 8:35 to go in the fourth quarter. Miami trying to answer to Akron's points. 20-17, your score here in the fourth. Miami football on Red Hawk Radio. Miami 20, Akron 17 with 8:35 to go in the fourth quarter, and the RedHawks here are going to begin another drive. And the last few ones, Luke, have not been very good. The Miami trying to run the ball, but they just haven't been able to go anywhere.
Yeah, you know, this is going to be an interesting drive to see how the RedHawks mix up the passing and rushing. Obviously, they're going to want to be a little bit mindful of the clock. You know, with the lead, you don't want to give Akron too much time if you are able to, you know, punch something in like a field goal. But obviously, too, you don't want to just keep running the ball up the middle and get stuffed like they did in the last drive and go three and out.
Pitch to the near side from Gabbert. Jalen Bester shoved out of bounds under the 26-yard line. And that is going to be a gain of 6 for Jalen Bester on the first down rush with exactly 8.5 to go in the fourth quarter. Hometown crowd, they kind of did leave at halftime. I'd say about 50%. I'd say about 70% of the students, though, stuck around. About 300 to start the game on the student side of things. Gabbert handoff here up the right hash, trying to move it for Miami was Davian Johnson. Johnson gained about 2 yards there, and it's going to be a 3rd and 2 from the 28-yard line coming up. And it's 7:46 to go in the fourth quarter.
Big 3rd down here for the RedHawks. Wouldn't be surprised if we see something a little bit different from Miami. Maybe not just a gut run as we saw in the last play on the last drive. You expect Akron to load the box here, and we'll see what Gabbert does.
Final home game of the year for the RedHawks football team. No receivers, the line rushing 9 players. Gabbert a play action fake. Now he's looking to pass and in trouble scrambling around the backfield. He is able to get to about a place where there's a 1 yard loss at the near side of the field. No gain on the play for Brett Gabbert. He did a good job scrambling. Could have lost about 10 yards, but able to retrace his steps. And it's going to be 4th and 2 for the Miami 28. And now decision time coming for Chuck Martin. And the RedHawks look like Luke are really thinking about going for it. Although now Kyle Kramer, the punt team, walks on with 21 on the play clock.
Yeah, you just can't go for it here. I think that maybe the RedHawks would debate it about maybe possibly trying to draw an offsides. But I think that Akron wouldn't really be fooled by that. As that would be a little bit aggressive, even for the most aggressive of coaches when you're up 3 points and you miss that 4th down and you put Akron right in field goal range right away. Not sure the RedHawks want to do that, so they're going to punt this one away.
Well, it's going to be from their own 28-yard line. A fair catch signal made by their returner, Jeremiah Knight. And with 6:25 to go here in the fourth quarter, the Zips will begin their next drive. 1st and 10 from their own 36-yard line, down by 3. Miami 27, Akron 17. It's Miami football on Red Hawk Radio. 6:25 to go here in the fourth quarter. Akron beginning another offensive drive, this time from their own 36-yard line. Two receivers to the right and one to the left here. Cato is back to pass from his own 30. Looking near side of the field, now decides to keep it up the left hash. He'll dance across the 40-yard line. And Nelson Cato will gain six on that rush to make it a second and four from the Zips 42. Metro Next Sports broadcast come your way November 28th and 29th from the XL Center in Hartford, Connecticut. Miami Hockey taking on UConn on the road. And then after that, the hockey team playing home December 6th and 7th against St. Cloud State. But that week also at men's basketball, December the 3rd, home against Northern Kentucky University. That game on Red Hawk Radio as well. Play action fake. Nelson up the near side. He will get a first down here on a keep. A little option that time for Cato Nelson, who just continues to really surprise the Redhawks with his rushing game tonight. Mentioned no yards on the ground last week in the game against Eastern Michigan. Came in with just 126 yards on the season, but Nelson now rushing up to 54 yards on the day. Three receivers right, one to the left here on a first and 10 for their own 48. Nelson again in trouble, rolls to the near side of the field, now decides to keep and was able to pick up about two through the near sideline there. Got hit hard into the Redhawks sideline, the near sideline, and now there's a little scrum going down there as a bunch of Redhawks players standing on the sideline trying to crowd around Cato Nelson, and Akron players coming in trying to get him up. They finally do. Loss of one actually on the play to make it second and 11 from the Zip Zone 47-yard line. Down to 5 minutes to go here in regulation.
Yeah, that's an improvement from the Redhawks. They're really just letting Nelson run all over them in the first little bit of this drive. Just getting some easy yardage there. They were able to get some pressure on him early and force a one-yard loss.
Two receivers right and one to the left here for Cato Nelson. And now we get a timeout and a whistle. Looks like Akron is going to take their first timeout of the half. So the Zips here will have two timeouts remaining with 4:40 to go in the fourth quarter. Second down and 11 coming up. And the Redhawks next week will be on the road against Ball State. Final regular season game of the year in Muncie, 12 p.m. Eastern, Friday, November 29th. Cardinals this year 3-3 in the MAC. They're third in the MAC West. Akron up next Tuesday. They'll be home against Ohio University, who beat pretty bad the Bowling Green Falcons last night. That's a 6 o'clock start for Akron on Tuesday night.
That's going to be a really tough game for Akron as well. Ohio was competing with Miami for that MAC East championship, and also now they sit, I believe, with a 5-6 record, so they need to win that game for bowl eligibility. So they're really going to want to win that game on the road. So a big game there for Akron next Tuesday.
Two receivers right, one to the left here. Nelson, an empty backfield on second and 11. In trouble again. This time he'll be brought down. All the way back to the Akron 45. A loss of two for the Redhawks. The ninth time Cato Nelson will be sacked tonight. Third and 13 coming up from Akron's own 45-yard line.
Yeah, the clock's running down a little bit here on Akron.
4:15 to go in the fourth quarter. Redhawks with a win tonight and a win against Ball State will give them the top record in the MAC for the first time since 2003. That's kind of what you're playing for here, I guess. And just more insurance for a bowl spot coming in with just 6 wins on the year. Nelson, another empty backfield, throw to the near side, and it's a catch, and Akron's going to get a first down on a clutch bring in there by the Zips number 5. That's Nate Stewart, the wide receiver, who was about 2 yards past the first down marker when he brought it in along the near side of the field, and it was shoved out of bounds by Rigumba.
And that's exactly what you want on Akron. If it's a third down, you want him to be just beyond the marker, able to find a little bit of space, pitch and catch for Nelson. Hit a pretty tight window, but overall a solid play for the Zips. First down for them into Miami territory now
And driving with the clock still running down, approaching 3 minutes to go here in the game.
3:26 to go in the fourth quarter as it's running up the near side of the field. That's Peter Hayes Patrick. He gets to the 34-yard line of Akron. That's a gain of 6 on the first down and 10 run. Now makes it 2nd and 4 with the clock still moving here with 3:06 to go in the fourth. And you imagine your loop. The strategy for Akron is run down the clock as much as you can and not give the Redhawks a chance to come back after maybe scoring a touchdown.
Absolutely. And, you know, with the Redhawks, especially if you're not able for the Zips to get a touchdown on this drive, you're forced to kick a field goal. Miami can storm down and kick a field goal with their great kicker. So
empty backfield. Nelson Penley coming here on Akron for holding is... He will fire it out the near side of the field. That was very apparent penalty. As flags came out when Nelson was trotting back to the near side of the field, escaping pressure. Akron's number 77, Xavier Gray, the guilty party. The Redhawks linebacker, Lonnie Phillips Jr., the defensive lineman, was trying to go after Cato and a clear hold there from the Zips. So 2:44 to go in the fourth. The clock stopped. It's going to be a 2nd and 13 coming up here for Akron for the Miami 44.
And that's a killer penalty there for the Zips. You know, now they're pushed way out of field goal range, needed to gain a lot of extra insurance yardage. And they got two downs to do it.
Three receivers right, one to left here for Nelson. Backfield empties out after the snap. Plenty of pressure coming in, and Nelson is sacked all the way back to his own 45-yard line. Cato Nelson brought down for the 10th time today. Three Redhawks that time, breaking through the line on a blitz. 3rd and 22 for Akron coming from their own 47-yard line.
Huge play. The Redhawks just get an edge sting right there. And Cato Nelson just trying to do a little shake and bake move there in the pocket, but when you're in that tight of a space, really tough to slip through. And Ivan Pace Jr. had none of that. Just put his whole body right into the chest of Nelson and dropped him for a huge loss. Now 3rd and 22 to go, approaching 2 minutes left in regulation.
This crowd on their feet. Nelson in empty backfield, still nowhere to go. He's scrambling around. Redhawks get to him, and Nelson fires it out the near sideline. There's nobody in the area. Chuck Martin wants a flag for intentional grounding. He's still motioning toward the referee to throw it, and now it comes out. It's going to be an intentional grounding penalty here against Cato Nelson after a pass on 3rd down and 22. And the Zips here, Luke, with two timeouts remaining, 1:50 to go in the fourth quarter, are going to have a 4th and 37 from their own 38-yard line.
Obviously, you have to go for it here. And this is obviously a big play for the Zips, but really shot themselves in the foot a lot of times towards the middle of this promising drive. And they've been pushed all the way back now to their own part of the field again. They're lining up to punt here with two timeouts. Not sure about this call.
Yeah.
Redhawks is going to be wary of a fake. They're actually not going to put any returners back.
Punt coming here from Akron. Weiland gets it off to no return. The ball bouncing off the 20-yard line to the near side of the field and escapes at the Miami 22-yard line. That's an interesting decision to not put a returner out there. As Weiland kicked it, landed at the 20, came out at the 22. Redhawks going to get the ball here. 1:40 to go in the fourth quarter. 1st and 10 from their own 23. Up 20-17 on Akron. Miami, three timeouts left. The Zips have two.
Yeah, and I like the decision from Chuck Martin. It ended up paying off, not putting any returner back there and risking anything on a fair catch, you know, a muff punt or anything like that. Don't think that the Zips got that punt as deep as they wanted it to get in the Redhawks territory, and now the Redhawks going to load the box here.
Raglan hands off up the right hash of the field. It is Jalen Bester on the rush, and this time gains about 2 yards. 1.5 minutes to go now in the fourth quarter. And the clock here just running. I'm surprised Akron hasn't called a timeout yet.
And the clock just stopped now.
Of course, we can't hear the referee, Mike.
So they reset 7 seconds back on it, and I think Akron took a timeout.
Referee just motioned that the Zips did call a timeout, in fact, and now the team's going back to their benches. Second and 8 coming up from the Redhawks' own 25-yard line. 1:36 to go in the fourth quarter. Miami 20, Akron 17, and the Zips now just have one timeout remaining. So they can stop the clock after the Redhawks run it on a third down. After that, the clock's going to run on a possible fourth down from Miami. So right now, Luke, if Miami gets another first down, this game's pretty much over.
Yeah, I really am not sure about the decision by the Akron coaching staff to punt that. I mean, I think that, you know, if you do happen to turn that ball over, which you're likely going to do just because of how far that fourth, well, it was fourth and 37, something
yep.
like that. So I'm not a big fan of that punt call. The Redhawks would have been in field goal range anyway. Even if they made this field goal, though, it would have been a six-point game, still within a touchdown. They're going to put one more second back on the clock here. But now you put a lot of pressure on your defense to just absolutely swarm the Redhawks. And get your timeouts in as quickly as possible and just try and score as fast as you can if you do get that ball back.
Hand off here to Bester again up the middle of the field after a snap on the right hash. And this time a gain of another 2 yards. Akron quick to call a timeout after the rush. 5 seconds go off the clock, so 1:31 to go now in the fourth quarter. It's going to be a 3rd and 5 coming up here from the Redhawks zone, 28-yard line. They're going to put 2 more seconds back on the clock, actually, so now 1:33 to go here in the fourth quarter. Miami 20, Akron 17, 3rd and 5 coming up from this Redhawks zone, 28.
And this really is a deciding play for how
yep.
Chuck Martin is as a play caller. We'll see if he just decides to go the safe route, put this one up the gut, and likely punt it away. I don't think he would pass. I don't think that would be I don't think that would be very feasible in this situation to
nope.
do. But maybe take a risk with, you know, a running back trying to bounce it towards the outside. I mean, Bester had a lot of room had he chosen to go to the outside on the last play. Obviously, he chose not to, probably at the instruction of the coaching staff just because of the risk of fumbles and turnovers and things like that. But I'll be interested to see on this next play how Chuck Martin drew it up and how the Redhawks will play it.
I mean, the way I look at it here, 5 more yards and you win the game.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, Akron can't stop the clock anymore. First down wins it. And the biggest play of the game thus far, Akron down 3. They need a stop here on defense.
1:33 to go in the fourth quarter. This game play might win it. Hand off to Bester. Finds a hole up the middle. Jalen Bester, first down Miami. All the way out to the 39-yard line. Clock moving with 1:28 to go in the fourth quarter. Akron can't stop it. They have no timeouts. And the Miami Redhawks here need just a few more plays to bring this one home after they string together what will likely be a nail-biting 3-point win over the Akron Zips. And the Redhawks still in contention for the top record in the MAC this season. And this win, Luke, will very likely probably solidify their position in a bowl game this season.
Absolutely. You know, last year you don't want to take any chances going 6-6 and missing a bowl game. This year now with 7 wins, it's got to really feel great for the coaching staff to just have fully secured everything in terms of bowls, not having to worry about whether or not you will see your name on selection day, but just worrying about where you will see your name on selection day. The Redhawks are going to down it here, and this is a great win here for the Redhawks as they squeak it out over the Akron Zips.
They're going to have to get one more snap off. They just took it one more knee. Play clock is about 6 seconds in front of the game clock here. So they will run each of those down, and the fans begin to hit the exits here at Yager Stadium tonight. Gabbard in the victory formation. He played the entire game for the Redhawks. 2 on the play clock. 1 more knee, and that is going to do it from Oxford, Ohio tonight. The Miami Redhawks beat the Akron Zips by a score of 20-17. The Miami Redhawks improved to 7-4 overall. They're now 6-1 in the MAC. The Zips fall to 0-11 overall, 0-7 in the MAC. And the Miami Redhawks just 1 win away from clinching the conference's top record for the first time since 2003. As the fight song here plays in Oxford, Ohio, and Luke Westpoley, our final regular season football broadcast of the year here on Red Hawk Radio, and pretty good season for the Miami Redhawks. What do you make of the win tonight?
Well, I think it's just a testament to how the RedHawks are able to play. I mean, you're playing a team in Akron that's yet to win a game. They're hungry to win a game, obviously, but clearly, you know, not quite up to the standard as the rest of the teams in this conference. And, you know, when you play against the lower-skilled teams, sometimes you play down to teams. I don't think the RedHawks played their best game of the year by any stretch today.
Nope.
But every good team has their tests against teams, you know, that they don't think they're going to be tested by in a game. And I think the RedHawks really did a good job here just squeaking out the win. Sometimes you just have to get through these type of games and come out in the win column and just kind of forget about how it was done or, you know, how many points you did it by and just be happy that you came out with a win. The RedHawks are going to be really happy they came out with a win here on their final home game of the season. And fight song playing here in Oxford. 3-point win here on some Wednesday night action.
Miami 20, Akron 17, your final score tonight. The RedHawks now with 7 wins on the season here from Yager Stadium tonight. All right, so for Luke Westpool and Ryan Jackson, our entire RedHawk radio crew, thank you so much for listening tonight and sticking with us through all those technical difficulties we had in the first quarter of the game. We called part of this one off of our laptop microphone, just one microphone, but we managed to get through this one tonight, and we appreciate you trying to get through it with us as well here on RedHawk Radio this evening. Miami RedHawks football in very good position heading into the postseason in the final regular season game against Ball State next Friday. So we hope you'll join us for the Friday after Thanksgiving. Miami hockey team in Hartford, Connecticut to take on the UConn Huskies. Game one of that series will be on RedHawk Radio from the XL Center, 4:05 Eastern, the Friday after Thanksgiving. That is Friday, November 29th. I'll be on the call for those games and hope you'll join us there from Connecticut. All right, that'll do it for us here on this evening. Luke Westpool and Ryan Jackson. My name is Patrick Geshan saying so long and good night from Yager Stadium this evening from Oxford. Miami 20, Akron 17, your final. It's been a presentation of Miami football on Red Hawk Radio. Have a great night, everyone.